What's up, guys, and welcome to another episode of TV Show Reviews with us from Our Love, Our Journey, the McCrays.
McCrazies.
The McCrazies. And my name is Joshua, and this is my beautiful fiance. Mrs. Joshua McCray Fitness. So, guys, today we got a sick TV show review, guys. We're going to do a show called Better Than Us on Netflix. Mm-hmm. Guys, this one's going to be a sick one, so stay tuned, and we'll see you guys in 1 minute. Peace. All right, guys, so first off, I would like to say I really freaking loved the show.
Yeah, I did too.
It was really, really good. Mm-hmm. It was, guys, the trailer sucks.
They need to get better at the
trailers. So we noticed this with the overseas TV shows, guys. The trailers do suck.
They're terrible.
However, I'll tell you, the show is sick, guys. Super. So what's it about, baby?
So it is like in the future. And then we have robots that are doing all of the things for us. So your nanny is going to be a robot. Your kid's best friend can be a robot. You can have like robots to do anything and everything. Like older people have robots to take care of them because they have like a heart attack or something. Like just all that fun stuff. So it is very like robotic. They have very specific rules. Like robots have to pretty much like servant, like listen to whatever the owner says. They can't kill, they can't hurt, they can't do any of that stuff. So
guys, it's a good futuristic show. So if you guys are interested in the future of technology and where technology is going, this is such a sick show for that, mm-hmm. to give you a good insight into what I think is probably actually gonna freaking happen. Mm-hmm. So let's go ahead and dive right in, guys. We're gonna go over three things each that we liked and three things each that we disliked. And let's dive right in.
Cool.
Okay, so first thing that you liked about it, babe.
I liked it was futuristic. I love future shows. Like when I was a young girl and Xenon the 21st Century came out and she was living in space, like I loved it. I love futuristic shows.
I do too, guys. And so that actually is one of mine. So let's go ahead and I'll start with that one. Okay. So it gives you a really good glimpse into the future, and it kind of shows you what we can kind of expect in the future of AI. AI, I think, will eventually be there. Will it be in our lifeline? Possibly toward the end, but if not, probably within the next 200 years. I think so. Yeah. And so in the next, because guys, technology is speeding. So
expanding fast.
It's just compounding on itself. So
I think cars you already have.
Oh my gosh, right? And so guys, like, I think if we can get this technology down, it will be amazing. It gives you a great insight of how awesome AI will be and how many jobs it will take away. But hey, it makes sense, right? Mm-hmm. That's the evolution of humans. So get smarter if you don't want to get left behind.
Yeah.
Cool, all right, number two, what's the second thing you like?
Kind of off of what you said, I love how our world is going to probably change and they'll probably have robotic assistants sometime in the, I'm guessing, near-ish future.
Well, another thing I liked was there was long episodes and there was plenty of them. Mm-hmm. So I think they're around an hour, mm-hmm. but and there was 16 episodes. So it's like 16 movies, right? That's a long time. It's like, you know, movies around an hour. So about 16 movies per episode.
Yeah.
So I thought that was really dope. All right. So number three, what's the third thing you liked there?
I loved, and I'm going to try my best not to make this a spoiler, but I loved the special robot because so all of the other robots were like very robotic, but the special robot could have more humanistic features. And I think that would be a useful thing for us to have for them to be able to feel rather than just be like, you know?
It shows the potential evolution of robots from an emotional standpoint.
Yeah.
Okay, so number three for me, guys, what was so dope was it was like a futuristic thriller, but they did such a good job on it because it wasn't cheese. It would be so easy, so hard to pull off something like this. It's a cheesy concept, you got robots. But they made it, they did a good job with it, right? Where it's not cheesy. So to me, I thought that was like really dope. I know it's hard to pull off. So the fact that they were able to pull off a TV show where it actually looked that good is good. I think it's really cool.
You guys, I would literally probably not watch the trailer if I were you because there's so many times we watched the trailer. I think we watched it 15 times before we decided. It looked so stupid.
Yeah.
It looked retarded on the trailer.
It did.
So don't watch the trailer and just listen to us.
Okay, guys. And actually, we never do this, but I got a few bonus likes that I like. So there's three of them. I'm just going to say them all back to back for you guys, okay? Because there was so much I liked about it, I couldn't fit it into my three. Okay, guys, so the ending of this show is different than most shows, so I will let you know that. I can't give you details because that would be a bad spoiler alert, and I'm being a good boy. Thanks to our video editors making us be a good boys and girls in the spoilers. However, the ending is better than most endings, I would say, for sure, for the TV shows we watch, you know, so it's a really good ending. I would say, guys, also, it's much higher production quality than it looks, especially from the trailer, but the production quality is actually pretty freaking good, so I can tell you put a lot of money into it, and I see some of the same actors in the show that I really like, so it has the actor from Into the Lake, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a show called Into the Lake. It has the same actor from it, and I love him, his role. He plays a similar role, but he's really cool. So he's the main character. So if you guys like him in the show, then I would suggest checking out Into the Lake. Okay. So that's it for things that we did like, guys. So now let's go over to three things that we disliked about the show. Mm-hmm. So start with you, man.
So to me, there were a few kind of like dead spots that got a little bit boring. Not a lot, but there was just those few. And then I seemed to like doze into La La Land when those things happen. So then it's hard for me to like jump back in, but there was just a few of them.
Great point. Okay, so mine kind of is like that, guys. And it just requires a lot of focus, in my opinion, because if you don't focus for a while, you might get a little mm-hmm. lost, especially with the characters, mm-hmm. right? So you got to pay attention because the character development is an important part of this show.
And a lot of them look alike.
They do, right? right? Yeah, so people told me today I look like the new Bachelor guy.
Oh, it's so funny. He does.
I doubt I do.
No, you do.
I have to Google him. But anyways, all right, so we think they look alike. That's it. Mm-hmm. So, okay, guys, so that's the one thing we both dislike. What's the second thing you dislike?
I actually only had two dislikes for this one as well. I just didn't, this is me going on like Pharisees, I didn't like how mean they were to the robots. There's still like things there to help you, like you don't have to be an a-hole. So I didn't like that.
Okay, so she wants equal rights for robots and humans. Okay, guys, and so the last thing I would say is a dislike is very similar to her first dislike. There was just a few dead spots, agreed. Okay, so my third and final dislike, guys, I would say is just a little bit more structure in the storyline would be great. It did feel to like jump around a lot, and so it kind of got a little confusing at times for me. However, I'm usually multitasking when I'm watching these shows anyway, so that could just be my bad focus. But I would say just keep an eye out for that, is you might have to single focus on it. And if they had a little bit more solid, easy to understand storyline, I think it'd be easier for people to follow and it'd be a better experience. It required a little bit of brain energy, which is not what you want to use too much of when you're watching a TV show, in my opinion. But that's probably my third and final dislike.
Yeah.
Cool. Right, so suitable for children, what would you say, babe?
Yeah.
Okay, I would agree. I think it is suitable for children. I don't think there was any nudity. Mm-hmm. If so, it was very small.
Yeah.
And yeah, right, exactly. What she does to me when we watch rated R movies.
Thank you.
Just playing. All right, so yeah, guys. So suitable for children. I said, yeah, go ahead and let them enjoy it. It's a great show, I think, for the family to watch. If I'd say more teenager. Mm-hmm. If they're teenagers, they'll like it. If they're kids, they might not as much. Yeah, they might just not get it. Yeah. And there is a little bit of murder and stuff in there. So I would say it's still suitable for 14, 15 year olds, but I'd keep it around that age range, 13 to 17. It's mm-hmm. okay, probably. Okay, and then final overall rating. What would you say on a scale 1 to 10, babe?
9.5.
Wow, okay, I think that's her highest rating yet, is a 9.5. My overall rating, I gave it a 9.25. Mm-hmm. So, I know we give a lot in that range, guys, but that's just what it was. It was a 9.25 mm-hmm. for me. So I thought it was really, really good. Okay, guys, so keep in mind, we are watching a show right now called The Barrier on Netflix. So if you guys are familiar with that, stay tuned in the next few weeks and we'll have a TV show review on there. Where are we at in the season? We're about halfway through. I think we're about halfway through right now. There's only one season, but guys, that show's freaking great. Mm-hmm. It's a really, really great show that reminds me kind of a show, very similar. So you'll see the trailer when we finish the show we're reviewing.
It reminds me a little bit of our 3% show too.
Yeah, so it's similar to 3%, it's similar to this show, and but it's futuristic, but it's really cool. So it shows what can go wrong in the future, and that's something that's really cool. So stay tuned for that one. And other than that, guys, thank you guys so very much for watching another amazing episode of Josh and Alex's TV Show Reviews.
Yeah.
So our Love, Our Journey TV Show Reviews. So if you guys have any questions, please let us know. If you guys have watched it, please let us know what you guys thought in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share. And we cannot wait to see you on the very next episode. Peace. See ya.